Hello again, fellow mask fanatics. You're in the mask fan attic once more. Thanks for stopping by. Always nice to see you here in the attic of Dr. Lady, where it's Halloween all the time. That's right. Round the clock, night and day, it's always Halloween here. Who cares what the calendar says, right? Now, in 1983, the movie Return of the Jedi came out, the third in the Star Wars series. But it took 13 years until 1996 for Don Post Studios to add this mask to their Star Wars collection. This one, again, from 1996, was called the Emperor's Royal Guard, sometimes just Imperial Guard, but the official original cataloged name of it was Emperor's Royal Guard, as they appeared in the 1983 hit Return of the Jedi. Now, I don't know how many of these were made, but it seems to have been a big hit right away. It was originally sold for neighborhood of $90 to $100, which makes it a little steep for mass-produced masks of 1996 dollars. But I saw the price go up a lot as soon as this and some of the others in the Star Wars line were discontinued. They started growing in value, and this seems to be one of the most sought-after and most pricey to obtain today. Not sure why that is, other than, again, obviously they didn't make as many of these as they did, say, Darth Vader or Boba Fett, because everybody wants to be Darth Vader or Boba Fett. Admit it, even you do. Sure. But not everybody wants to be an Emperor's Royal Guard, or so it was thought, so they didn't make as many of these. As you can probably tell, instead of the traditional Don Post latex, this one is made out of rigid plastic. And what's that? You'd like to try it on? Why, sure. Here, you just go ahead, just try that on. And you see, when you look through it, everything looks sort of red and pink, because even the plastic lens is tinted red, you see? And, all right, anyway, the old guard here may have been popular because it has this nice kind of mysterious elegance to it. And the other thing I think that makes it a nice choice as a wearable mask is that it's so easy to costume. All you need is some red fabric to hang all over yourself like a big long red robe or a big long red cloak. Kind of easy to costume, although not, of course, if you wanted to look 100% movie accurate. You'd have to go to a little more trouble than that and make sure that the fabric is cut and styled in the right way and all that. But for just general Halloween party use, or you know, to wear to a convention or to wear at your science fiction themed haunted attraction for Halloween, you could get away with just a long red robe, right? Or a long red cloak with this very cool hard plastic helmet. The only thing I thought was a little disappointing about it, you can probably tell this, the area where the visor goes, okay, is not cut all the way out like it looks in the film. So the result is that the piece of glued on red tinted plastic that's on here is larger than the opening that's cut in the mask. You see that? And that throws the look of it a little bit for me. I would have preferred that they cut the whole area out, but then of course they wouldn't have any place to put the glue to hold the little piece of plastic onto the visor area. So then if they didn't want to do that, I think another good thing to do would have been to paint the surrounding area in there flat black, to just hit that with flat black paint, and then when you put the red plastic on, it would all kind of come together a little better and nobody would notice that the whole area isn't cut out. Yes, I've had one of these since 1996, and I have yet to take that visor off and paint that flat black and then stick it back on. Although I sometimes continue to kid myself that I'm eventually going to. Maybe by the time you watch this video, I will have taken that piece of plastic off and painted the whole visor area in black and fixed it. Okay, don't place bets on that at this point, but it is possible. I might do that. 1996 Emperor's Royal Guard. We'll see you again next time here in the Mask Fan Attic. For now, I'm just going to put this on and go guard the Emperor.